I still don't look red. I'm still going to do my vlog about Mary Sue writing. But first I want to talk about organization, because I feel that's very important about becoming a writer. And I think that I have some little tips that might help you guys if you're just starting out a novel, or if you are kind of in the midst of it and need a little bit of help just going through a few more hurdles. Excuse me. Well, this is about keeping your work. One thing I used to do a lot, I used to have a lot of notebooks. And the thing about notebooks is that once you run out of pages, you're out of pages, and then you keep getting another notebook, and you just had a bunch of notebooks with different kind of information in it. Sometimes you bring your notebooks to school if you're still a student, you end up mixing them up with your regular books, writing stuff inside the notebook that you're not supposed to put in there. It's also very, you know, heavy to carry around sometimes. Or if you're like me, you want a really pretty notebook, so you kind of buy a pretty notebook, then you see another pretty notebook, you want to buy another pretty notebook, you keep redoing things, redoing things, redoing things. It's redundant and you end up just wasting your time. So what I decided to do was that I got a binder instead. And I got one of these binders from Staples, and it was really good because it has enough pages for me to have in the rings, and it has this kind of like this little paper thingy in the front where I can remove and take pictures, so I can always change the cover. Like right now I have this with all some of my favorite people on there. I used to have this one on there, and before that I used to have this one. And you guys just saw my real name. Hope you guys can figure out which one it is. Okay, and then we have inside. Don't want to show you too much. But they give you the folder, and this is good for you can keep little notes. Like, I have little character notes on here. You know, I have my character chart, which you guys will see later on, that I found on the internet. I'll show it to you later on in the Mary Sue video. And then you also have tabs. Like, I separated the tabs to have different things. Like, this is real life stories, the witch novel, Larissa's novel, cash sheets, and other projects. Now, what I did with, I'll show you an example of one thing I did. When I have them separated by the tabs, I also have different things. Like, I'll have in, like, for the front page, I'll have the name of one of the main characters, the name, the age, date of birth, blood type, and their role. So this way, if you have a bunch of characters, sorry about my phone, you can just go and quickly go through it, and you can just be like, well, this is this character, and then you go and you flip again, you can find, oh, this is the other character in a series. That way you can keep it all nice and neat and organized. One thing I've also learned to do with this is more like organizing your plans. Like, I have one page that I'll have in front of the character sheet that's called plot notes. I don't want to give you too much about my story. Plot notes, and it will like basically say what you want to say. Like, I'll have outline for Larissa's story, you know, 3 books long, first book, blah, 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 second book, blah, 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 third book, blah, blah, blah. Name for each book. These are all work in progress names. I got like book 1, Oleander, book 2, Viscera, book 3, Faded Roses. That's really lame, but I changed that. And then I have like the chapters and what each chapter is about. Now, plot notes are different from plot summaries. Plot notes will only have like one sentence that really says like the gist of what that chapter is about. Then you have, of course, the character sheets, and then you have the information. What I think is a good idea, I didn't finish doing it for my character sheets, but for what you can do is, when you have a character sheet, you number the pages, and next to the number, you put like the initials of that character. I haven't put it yet, but I am going to. This way, you know all the organization of what it is. Like, if something goes missing, you know it's missing because it's going to have all the numbers on it. So you have like, this is Kimiko, so it's Kimiko. Her name is Kimiko L. Hitari. So it's KLH1. So that one will work for you. With the cash sheets, what I learned was good about using this was you have the names of all the characters, right? And then this highlight, it says highlight is for people who are going to have full character charts, which is like this 5-page sheet of how to like outline your character. It's in, like, picking which characters are going to get highlighted tell you which is going to be your main characters and which are going to be your minor characters. That way you don't spend a lot of time going to depth into characters that don't have like a really huge role in the plot, because what you want to do is make sure that your main characters have all the information they need, and that your secondary characters have information, but you're not like spending as much time on them as you would your main characters and your main secondary characters. So that's what I did with that. And, you know, that's basically it in the back. And, you can, and the thing about this is you can add and subtract as much paper as you want so you don't use as much. So I would really suggest getting a binder and not a notebook. That's that. Another thing I use is I use a notepad. Now, I wouldn't suggest getting one like this because the point is a lot of young writers, we're going to school, we have a lot of notebooks to carry. You don't want to carry another big, thick notebook. So what I would suggest is you get a smaller one. You have an example? Yeah, one that's about like this big and you can carry around your book bag. These notebooks are just for like making little jottings because sometimes you'll have a random idea or you'll hear something interesting or find out something interesting in school or sometimes and you just want to like write it down and you don't want to have to carry this binder around with you. That's why you carry the notepad. The notepad will be your travel along and your binder will be like your official notes and everything. And then the third thing I use are index cards. I haven't opened these yet because I just got them from Staples. And this was actually an idea I got from one of my books. The book is called Plot and Structure by James Scott Bell. And he explains in one chapter something called the index card system. And I will scroll to show you guys what that is right now. It's where you basically use the index cards to put little brief jottings about what's going to happen. Like this example, it's like it says, because I know you can't see, Monica drives to John's house, chased by bikers, saved by fireman Dan. So you can basically use these index cards kind of like in between your notes and your binder. You can use it to like make jottings about anything and kind of organize it. Like what I did, because this is 500 cards, each 100 will represent a certain thing. One is going to be for plot, one is going to be for characters, one is going to be for dialogue, one is going to be for specific scenes. And the last one is just going to be for miscellaneous things as extra. And it's good to have these things separate. I would also suggest maybe getting them in different colors if they're cheap. If they're not cheap, don't spend the money. Just get regular index cards. And this way, you can have it separated. And it's also very easy to just pick and throw away what you don't want when you have index cards. Instead of having like a whole sheet of paper and you forget plot, you have to throw away a whole sheet of paper. No, you just have these little index cards. You can pick and choose what you want, switch it up if you need to. And it's very handy to come along with. I've tried it with other index cards before, but not just this pack specifically. But I really think it's a good idea. One recommendation about when you buy the paper for your binder. I use two different kinds of paper. I have this kind of cheap 99 cents paper, but it's still college ruled, as you can guys can see. And I use this to make like little notes things. And then I have like this really, really nice paper that I use for when I have the actual information and like permanent stuff. And I was just having the two different kinds just so you can separate what's going in and what's not. Because sometimes you end up having a lot of clutter around and a lot of papers running around. And you don't know what you're keeping, what you're not. You have to go rereading it. Color coordinating things helps a lot. And I would really suggest always buy a college ruled paper because you have more lines and you can spend less on it. And that's just a little organization tip that I have. And the next video I will do will be about Mary Sue's. I hope that was helpful for you. And I'll see you guys soon. Love ya.